Klaxoon.
Hey Tim, it's Klaxoon.
Hello and welcome to our latest Klaxoon Live. My name is Charles, and for the next 30 minutes, we'll be exploring new ways of working and the future of work. So if you've come to one of our lives before, you know we talk about meetings and workshops and trainings. We talk about teamwork, and we're talking about always getting the best out of your collective because we're trying to solve problems. And if we're getting things right in the office, we should be thinking about this maybe outside of the office as well, and how collective intelligence can impact solving problems everywhere. So today we're going to talk about saving our oceans, which is super important, and how collective innovation can be a huge factor in helping. So I'm joined today by Marta Cavazos, who is the Program Accelerator Lead at Sustainable Ocean Alliance. Hi, Marta.
Hello. Hi, everyone. Thank you for having me.
It's terrific to have you, and so many things here that's going to be exciting to learn about. But I want to learn about you. Tell us about yourself.
So my name is Martha. I'm talking to you from my apartment in Detroit today, where I live and reside. I am the Accelerator Program Lead and come with an extensive background as a facilitator, from international volunteer programs to global leadership development conferences, and recently got the opportunity to combine my passion for the ocean with my passion and experiences in program design and community and network development. And I'm really excited to talk to you all today about what the Ocean Solutions Accelerator is this year and how we enjoy working with Klaxoon.
Great. So Sustainable Ocean Alliance, can you tell us more about it?
Yeah, so we are a global community of leaders, entrepreneurs, and ocean solutionists that are committed to preserving and protecting the ocean. We, specifically in the Ocean Solutions Accelerator, are focused on supporting and accelerating businesses that are related to the UN Sustainable Development Goal 14, which is all about conserving and protecting the ocean. So that's really our center, is the UN SDG 14.
So we talk about our worlds, the oceans, and I actually live near the ocean, and it's fairly recent. And whenever there's a storm, I'm always kind of shocked by the amount of plastic that turns up with the seaweed, right? And my daughter, who's five, is, you know, I don't know where she gets it from, but she goes and she picks out all the plastic.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
And puts it in a cup, and you know, we put it in the recyclable bin, right? That's not a very scalable process for a five-year-old. So I'd like to understand what you guys are thinking about on this sense, and why you set up this accelerator, and how that it was in a physical location before. Tell us a little bit about that and why that's so important that we need to do this now.
Right, absolutely. Well, I will say thank you to your daughter, because individual action does matter. And at the same time, we believe that for-profit, market-driven, innovative solutions are what is really going to be able to lay the groundwork for the future blue economy that we want to be instrumental in building today. So the Ocean Solutions Accelerator was co-founded with our CEO and organizational founder, Daniela Fernandez, along with our Chief Innovation Officer, Craig Dudenhofer. Together, they launched the first cohort in 2018. And you're right, Charles, the origin of our program is based where our roots are, in the Silicon Valley. And back in the pre-pandemic days, the program was about 8 weeks long, including an intensive experience in Silicon Valley, connecting and meeting with investors and other entrepreneurs. And then about four weeks at sea, actually, where the entrepreneurs, mentors in our network were able to really get hands-on with the impact that they're driving to positively impact the ocean. I'm sure we'll get to this. We have obviously morphed since, but really, again, you know, while we recognize that a lot of the companies we're working with, such as creating reusable packaging for takeout containers, developing kelp jerky and burgers to fundamentally shift our food system, these solutions absolutely rely on the individual actions, like we said, with your daughter. However, we believe that we have to be able to make significant investment and create ultimately a network of support so that entrepreneurs aren't doing this work in isolation. Mentors aren't doing this work in isolation. Your daughter isn't doing this work in isolation. We have to bring these ideas and these solutions together through our program and through our network that will really drive that systemic change that we want to see happen.
It's wonderful and so important. So you're kind of, in the past, you were getting everybody together, which sounded like a great party. You're doing this in San Francisco, and you're getting these great minds together all in the same room to solve a major challenge. And it's already hard enough. And a year ago, just made it a little more challenging, right? Because your cohort of startups, of companies, couldn't come in that same room anymore. What were you guys thinking back then when that happened? What was your first initial thought?
Right, absolutely. Well, to speak on behalf of the organization, you know, I think we were very similar to so many different businesses and nonprofits. We are a nonprofit. And so, you know, really ensuring that the products and the programs that we offer align not only with the direction of the solutionists that we're serving and also our funders, it was challenging. It was really tough. And, you know, I joined the team as a consultant in June and then full-time in this position in August. And so really getting the chance to kind of come into the team as we were actively iterating and actively reflecting. It was a lot of quick decisions like so many of us had to make, and also a real sense of urgency that I think, you know, so many folks in the nonprofit industry at large balance with our causes, but especially in working to preserve our ocean and mitigate the impact of climate change, that, you know, some of the first weeks that I was on the team in September, we had coworkers that were impacted by the fires in California at the same time that we were working to launch our first virtual cohort in October. And so really just being centered in the world that we live in was essential. And so that's how we, in a long story short, you know, made the decision to bring the cohort together virtually. There was no real way that we were going to miss a year, an opportunity to support these businesses and continue to build the network. But it was tough to make that response, to bring companies together, to bring speakers together. And I'm sure we'll talk more. We're pretty proud of what we created. We're looking forward to this year too.
So the whole team became remote, the whole SOA team became remote. And you're still deciding to go and say, hey, we're still going to do this. We're not sure how we're going to do this. We're going to do it virtually with startups from around the world, and we have to make this work. Why did you guys decide to use Klaxoon to do that?
So we knew that a virtual tool like Klaxoon was going to be essential. The SOA team historically spent tons of time together in the co-working space. So not only were we looking for something that was going to bring that sense of connection, collaboration, ideation on our just now newly distributed team, but we also really, as you heard me say earlier in the program in person, we're really focused on building relationships between our network of mentors, between our network of investors, and ultimately between the entrepreneurs themselves. We did our program in October. If you all are listening in, you might also remember being a little bit Zoom fatigued at that time, which, by the way, thank you for being here today. And so we had to think of ways to, on our team, to develop and implement the program. And then for the cohort and the program itself, not only continue to build that connection, but create another flow of engagement that was separate from a lot of this inundation of constant screen time. And Klaxoon allowed us to do that for so many reasons.
Well, I mean, an accelerator program like that, it's so short, it's so intense already, right? So you're asking a lot of the startups already, even if they're in the same room, you're kind of doubling that when you're doing it virtually. Yeah. I'd love to see, do you have some, maybe share your screen, show us some of the things that you did and explain to us how.
Yes, absolutely. So give me a second here and I'm happy to share my screen. And really, Charles and folks listening in, what I'll say is you can see probably zoomed in right away. This is from the program itself. We have weekly cohort reflections, which are really essential in executive leadership development and in entrepreneurship development, which is so much of what our program focuses on. The practice of reflection and ideation is, it has to happen, especially throughout the intensity of the 4 weeks. So one of our favorite templates that we used for these weekly reflections is this retrospective. And our partnership with Klaxoon allowed us to really speak one-on-one with the Klaxoon team. And they helped us decide together based on our needs, what templates would be most helpful. So you can see this kind of right in the center here. And in our weekly founder reflections, to build connection amongst the cohort, everyone participated in this cohort retrospective, looking back on the last week, thinking about the week ahead, so that again, you know, thinking about collective action, together as a cohort, we were able to reflect, create ideas, and develop the next best step. Which is what our program is focused on overall, and then especially in the week by week, day to day. So this is one board you can see over at the end, and someone made this section really big here. We had a takeaway and a commitment as well too. Charles, one of the other boards that I'm excited to share with folks is really a board that we used as our team. This board helped us be more efficient and work asynchronously together. And we met as a team as we were implementing the program on a weekly basis. And we still use this format on our weekly team meetings today. We're getting ready to build our program for this year ahead. And what you'll see here, what I really like about this template is that it's kind of our virtual working world. We work across 4 different time zones just on our mini accelerator team within SOA. And here we're able to, for each team member, you'll see we've got a little ocean creature there, of course, so we can really personalize it. You can see we've made this kind of our own with the waves and sea creatures too. More importantly, we're able to share through color coding that we designed our different to-dos and tasks for the week. We create brainstorming space for other program ideas and pivots that are happening. We share out our numbers. Right now, we're really focused on recruitment. So this is just an incredible tool, again, for us to really remember that while we are working alone, whether we're on the SOA team or an ocean entrepreneur, you know, we all are connected. And that's part of a lot of what we're working towards and creating the spirit of collaboration at the organization. And so Klaxoon allows us to do that for our program and for our teams.
That's awesome. I'd love to go back to the accelerator board that you had a second ago. And I just want to tell me again, how many people are involved in those 4 weeks of an accelerator? How many startups, how many mentors, how many investors, how many from your team?
Yeah, so overall, we have about 10 people from our team touching the program. Mm-hmm. We had 9 companies participate in the program, which meant that we had at any given time, anywhere from 9 to 20 founders participating in any of our sessions or Zoom calls. Mm-hmm. We have over 150 mentors in our network, and we're growing our investor network similarly now. This year, we are looking forward to using the Klaxoon board even more with our mentors and investors. What you don't see here today is the way that we use Klaxoon for the one-on-one meetings between the entrepreneurs and the mentors. So we suggested, we created templates that we intended to encourage really impactful conversation between the entrepreneurs and the mentors. We kept those confidential as well. But you know, here you'll see again, these are mostly the reflections from our founders. And we liked this function for our reflections too, because they could be anonymous. You can't always necessarily get that on Zoom anymore. You're immediately associated with your headshot, your name. We wanted folks to be able to just share where they were at emotionally, mentally, and this is what Klaxoon also allowed us to do too.
I love how you're using the templates in multiple ways. I mean, number one, with the retrospective, which is really important to debrief. And I think when you're doing so many things in a week, and we're all so busy now with a billion meetings, and those startup founders are thrown into sort of a lot of things at once, and to be able to debrief in a, as you're saying, anonymous way, I think is a really smart thing to do. What happened with communication? How effective? And maybe I think when we were talking about this before, you guys were pleasantly surprised how well everything went, even though it was your first experience doing the accelerator virtually in terms of communication.
Mm-hmm. Yes, collaboration. Absolutely. And so this is why you can probably see if you're checking out my shared screen now that I'm going back to kind of our team virtual world, because I want to highlight how important this was as essentially our source of truth for what was in movement throughout the program. We were able to use this board to detail founders' feedback, to detail mentors' feedback, to detail our priority for the week, many priorities for the week, and then generate action items from there as well. The collaboration during the program needed to be fast-paced. So we needed a tool like Klaxoon that was going to be able to respond to that. A Google Doc, a deck, we use Slack as well. That wasn't going to be able to organize and then generate action in the same way that Klaxoon was able to really offer us throughout the program too.
So you've used Klaxoon with great success during the accelerator program, but you've kept on using it as a team since then. We're seeing the board here, and you guys have continued to grow. So onboarding, making sure that everyone has like a visual canvas to keep on, you know, building ideas. And you have this brainstorming section. Can you tell us about that?
So yes, I would love to. One of my favorite sections because I love ideas. And, you know, as a distributed team, and to your point, Charles, with several new team members now building our two virtual programs for this year, we need a space to be able to capture these ideas so that when we come together for our meetings as a team, we can reflect back on what is on Klaxoon as a stepping off point for our next steps as a team. And so we use this brainstorming space to come up with ideas. You can see a little bit here, we're talking about content for the program. We are talking about what we could do as additional programming components. This is a way for us all, we can all kind of add our names on to each post-it note. We can each select colors like we do for each of our weekly priorities as well. And Charles, I think we were chatting about this before. What's also really helpful in onboarding is to really have a sense of what the new team is working on without ongoing communication on Slack, without ongoing checking in on Zoom. We can see transparently. So we can really, speaking of the future of work, really create a level of transparency and collaboration without always needing to be checking in or always on Zoom. Our team can have a kind of decentralized view of the landscape of their team. And this is another reason why we really like to use Klaxoon in our program, because while we don't speak about, have a specific section about the future of work, we bring in Klaxoon as a tool that represents the way that collaboration can and should be in the future across our teams and organizations. You know, decentralized, cross-pollination, lots of ideas, accessible across the globe, helpful for asynchronous work. Those are all things that we really want to be encouraging the entrepreneurs in our program to be utilizing in their teams so that they can scale and create impact to preserve our ocean. And so we want to be able to model that internally as well too.
Yeah, you're saying so many great things. I mean, we totally feel the Zoom fatigue and the anxiety or the burnout that creeps in. And working asynchronously is a great way to combat that, right? You're giving time for people to be innovative and to be able to do deep work without, you know, the constant messages that might bombard people. And I think you're doing a wonderful job here using this way with your team. And I see that you guys are making visual progress mm-hmm. on a daily basis together. I'm interested because you're a facilitator and a facilitator at heart, right? And you really want to get people involved. And you, when we talk about collective intelligence, I think that's part of getting facilitation right. How has your mindset changed over the last few months because of what's happened?
Oh man, that is such an incredible question. I think about this often. I obviously very much miss the same energy of being in a room with people. However, what I think Klaxoon can do is really create, again, those moments of reflection, connection, and those aha moments that I, as a facilitator, but highly value creating in those in-person and now virtual spaces. And that's why you can see I brought up right away the weekly founder reflections. I maintain that those are some of the most important parts of the program because they allow synthesis. And actually reflective practice is a really overlooked component to productivity, which ultimately is so important to many of us, especially the entrepreneurs we serve. And so as a facilitator, I want to ensure that we continue to use tools like Klaxoon that generate that sense of connection, those learning moments, and build in that reflective practice that ultimately leads us to be more productive in our workspaces and in our world in preserving the ocean as well. And, you know, really one of the additional things that I'll add is as the facilitator, where my intention is also to create, to eliminate a sense of isolation. Entrepreneurship can be so isolating, and especially when you're working in climate change. I know that this sounds minor, but one of my longer term hopes is that when folks are utilizing Klaxoon, they're able to, in the same way that you log into Zoom and you're able to kind of generate a connection, relationship with folks. I want Zoom to be one of the tools that we offer as part of our program, as part of our network, to feel less alone in this work overall too.
Yeah. So everyone at home, there is a Q&A. Feel free to throw your questions in there. We'll be super excited to answer them. Did you have another board to show us more quickly?
Just another founder reflection board that is kind of cutesy and fun. We liked to use this weekly mood barometer. Again, just combating the integration of Zoom. Oftentimes, I think folks will bring in a check-in round, one word of how you're feeling, use the chat, etc. Thumbs up, some thumbs down. We liked to build this in to Klaxoon. Let's take a, well, while we're together on Zoom during these sessions, this tool allows us to be a little bit more hands-on. And this is one of the boards that we use for that too.
Cool. Mm-hmm. I see someone had a question about the templates, and we have over 200 templates, so we won't cover them all today, but invite everyone, if you're interested by collecting templates, go to klaxoon.com/template, and you can, there's a ton of stuff there you can find, and you can find the retrospective that Sustainable Ocean Alliance is using right now. Mm-hmm. There's a question from TJ, and TJ lives in Newfoundland and the Labrador in Canada. How can I become involved in the Sustainable Ocean Alliance, he asks.
Great, thank you for asking. So TJ, we would love to connect with you more. You can first of all, check out our website. It's soalliance.org. I invite you to specifically check out our Ocean Solutions Accelerator page. It'll tell you more about our 2021 program. If you are an entrepreneur, TJ, I would love for you to email me directly. That my email is simply martha@soalliance.org, and we can talk a little bit more.
So tell me, if we're done with the screen sharing to you, but tell me a little bit about what you expect going forward, right? And, you know, mm-hmm. you've done now the program 100% virtual. Mm-hmm. What happens next, do you think, for teamwork in general in a hybrid type of world? What are you expecting from this?
I expect to be surprised, first and foremost. I expect that, you know, our team and the entrepreneurs participating in both our June and September cohort this year will also have different ideas. I want a tool like Klaxoon to also, you know, make space to hear how teams are collaborating. I would imagine that we'll see a similar type of trend that has already been mentioned a few times around general Zoom fatigue. You know, we're already planning to have fewer sessions, but more one-on-one time between our facilitators, our speakers, our mentors, just to create more engagement and less convening on Zoom. Of course, there will still be that, but we're anticipating that type of fatigue. We're imagining working towards next year in 2022, some in-person time. And I will say, you know, one of the main reasons why we don't have that in place for this year is not only because of the surprises and twists at every turn now in our world, but also because, you know, really as a result of our virtual programming last year, we were able to have our most global cohort in our accelerator. 7 out of the 9 countries were from outside of the US, which we're really proud of, and it really represents our continued global alliance and mission. And so I anticipate more of that. I anticipate even more companies to be a part of our program from outside of the US, which means that as we look towards in-person gathering, tools like Klaxoon will continue to be essential because we will have to find ongoing ways to be asynchronously connected with each other as well.
Mm. So you think from in this world that might be more hybrid going forward, you're definitely keeping some of the core things that you used this time around.
Absolutely. We're still adopting it. You know, we're still adapting. I don't think any of us here, you know, entrepreneurs or otherwise, have arrived at clarity in our pandemic lives. And so we need to be nimble. Over 200 templates were amazing. Let's be nimble. Let's utilize that. We're going to be more creative with how we use templates this year. We're going to continue, like I said, to integrate a little bit more one-on-one conversation, phone conversation during the programming. And the hybrid model will just continue, I think, some of that variety of the way that we facilitate the experience as well.
Mm. I think you guys have done a wonderful job, and I hope that you continue to be successful. Why is collective innovation so complicated? Why do we have such a hard time with it, right? It should seem easy. Hey, we've got a big problem. Yes. We'll solve it a lot faster if we come together and we work together and mm-hmm. we share our ideas and we feel safe and we really, you know, find a solution. But what's in your experience, and maybe you guys aren't the great example because you're so successful at solving problems, but why do you think this is so tough?
I would love to have a huge conversation on that. One of the reasons why I think it's tough is because our culture drives us to think that we can make change individually. We have a high value, especially, you know, we're an American-based organization. While we are global, we have a high value on individualism. And I think that's one of the ways we get so many innovative and creative ideas into our space. I think one of the challenges is finding the balance between valuing individual innovation, whether that's the single entrepreneur or the company's idea, and systemic accountability, which means, you know, here at SOA, we also work on deep seabed mining campaigns. We work on cross-organizational collaboration to ensure that the highest standards are met for our companies and that our companies have access to policymakers as well, too. I think we're figuring that out, and it's never going to become simple. These are complex challenges, and they require complex solutions. I just shared one idea of why I think it's complex, and I don't expect us to have the answer.
No. But I think you guys are giving others a great example on what to do. What's next for you guys? What's coming up?
So we have two cohorts this year. So two different accelerator programs that we're running. Our first cohort is going to be beginning on June 7th for 4 weeks, followed up by a demo day on July 8th. And our next cohort will be in September on September 7th, followed up by a demo day on October 7th, I believe as well. So we're doubling down this year. Our goal is to accelerate 21 companies in 2021 through our program. And we will continue to bring in the most innovative solutions that are addressing the UN SDG 14. Like I said, we anticipate a continued global reach. And that also means bringing in new, exciting speakers, facilitators, mentors, investors, and our growing network as well. So we've got a fresh team that will be focused on that network development and growth. And we're really excited.
Mm-hmm. I know we're getting close on time. If anyone has any more questions, please throw them in the chat. What if a startup is, or someone, an entrepreneur has a great idea? Can they take part?
Absolutely. We want you to apply. So we are calling all ocean technology entrepreneurs, whether you're at the idea stage, whether you are planning to close your Series A, our cohorts are going to be, and our program will be designed to focus on both early stage and later stage companies. We provide you with a network, access, post-program funding, the talent and skills that you need to really take your business from here to the next level. So I invite you again to go to soalliance.org or find me at martha@soalliance.org. I'd love to hop on the phone and talk to you more about your idea and how you can be a part of our alliance and our network.
And of course, you guys will be using Klaxoon this year as
well,
right?
The whole way through.
Terrific. Excellent. Very, very amazing. And I hope you guys continue to be successful because we need it. If you guys are inspired like I am right now after hearing Martha, we have a free trial, 3 months going on. I highly suggest that you try it and you maybe try some of the techniques that you've seen here from the weekly template to the retrospective, or just making sure that you're getting the best ideas your team has. So check that out. Everything we do at Klaxoon is about teamwork, and we have a great team always making these lives awesome. And I want to give a shout out to the people behind the scenes, behind the camera. You don't get to see them all the time. There's Julie. Hi, Julie and Seb. Thanks for everything you guys do because it's pretty amazing. Martha and the whole SOA team, thank you guys. You guys picked up Klaxoon super fast. There was hardly any time. I remember being with Ben, and Ben, wave at you too. I know you're listening. And you guys picked it up so fast. Were you surprised by that?
Oh yeah, I was surprised. And also, what a fast year. You know, we had to respond quickly. And I want to take this time to thank you, Charles, and the whole Klaxoon team, because it certainly wasn't a matter of just us picking it up. It was also a matter of us being on the phone with you, your team, reviewing the templates, communicating our needs, and really, you know, getting that customized support through our partnership. So yes, we did pick it up quickly and we didn't do it alone.
Terrific. So I wish you the best of luck for this cohort and this program. We really need you guys to succeed. So keep on doing it and keep on using Klaxoon because you're doing great. Martha, thank you again. It's been really awesome.
Thank you so much for the opportunity, Charles. And thank you all for joining. I hope to chat with some of you later.
And I invite everyone, if you missed part of this live or you want to see some of the other lives, Klaxoon replay page on our website. Don't miss that. See you soon. Klaxoon out.